robins are all singing their night song before they go to bed. Having a good smoke here. Some Hell's Kitchen. Hell's Kitchen. Just love to say it. Balkan Deluxe. From Hearth and Home. Really a nice label. Sophisticated. New York Pipe Club's collection of pipe tobaccos reflect the historic and vibrant character of our city. Our Balkan blend is dominated by complex and exotic oriental leaf. Can taste that. Fragrant and lightly sweet. Cyprian Latakia and dark-fired Kentucky. It's kind of unexpected. The Kentucky. You know, it kind of merges into a kind of a rich, beefy brew rather than individual elements. I like it though. Cool. Yeah, that's neat. Having a little non-alcoholic blend from the UK. It was on sale. It was $5 a six pack. Couldn't pass it up. So I'm kind of always volunteering for the fire department. So I don't drink nearly as much as I probably would otherwise. Not that I'd be a drunk or anything. But I like beer. I like whiskey. This is okay. It's nothing great. You know, kind of my favorite non-alky beer is Coors. Maybe because I grew up in Golden, Colorado. When we'd go to school in the morning, like high school, I lived far enough away. It was like 4 miles. So I would often take the bus, school bus, and we'd drive along the mesa, along Clear Creek, above the brewery down in the valley. It just consumed the whole valley. Be a frosty, snowy morning. Then the road would drop down and go under part of the brewery where they had expanded and built out over the road, 32nd Avenue. And on those mornings, it would smell like you were inside of a loaf of bread. I mean, it was intense. Not good though. That's good. I like it. It's not great. Is that my usual refrain? Anyway, I'm smoking a CustomBilt. Pretty much of a, not an Oompaul, but getting there. And this is a more refined, the Wally Frank years had a similarity, and they were kind of a more refined, less rusticated, like an old root. I like it. From the stamp, I can tell it's a later Wally Frank custom. Gives you some flavor. Yeah, that's good. Hell's Kitchen. Anyway, I'm smoking a CustomBilt. Because Matches 6-0 did a real nice video. Thanks, John. I don't deserve any of that. I just make these videos so I can smoke with somebody, right? I mean, it seems weird to me to say that, but that's how it is. There isn't quite the give and take, sadly, of a conversation. But it's much more like smoking with a small group than it is smoking alone. So maybe there's something psychotic there, I don't know. Anyway, it's after work. Thursday evening. We've got some meetings tomorrow. It's going to be kind of hectic. So I thought, well, I'll leave a little early tonight. It's kind of cloudy. I thought it'd stay lighter than this. Hopefully this will come out and it's not too dark. We'll see. Anyway, I had given Doug Owen a cargo hold a custom build. Well, I took some over and he picked one out. And turns out it was a Tom Howard. Which also, I have a few of those. And they're nice pipes too, from about the same period. I'm thinking more late 40s into the 50s, into the early 60s. So apparently Tom Howard was a radio personality. So his pipes have, some have a similar rustication, not quite the same. But they're more caricatures. They're more a little overdone, some of them, I think. That's just me. It turns out that was a Tom Howard. Oh, well. So we got to get you a custom build. We'll work on that. Yeah. But anyway, real nice video. So. And, yeah, this whole community is just freaking awesome. This was just the perfect way to